Corb Lund from the Canadian Rocky Mountains, and this is my Opry debut.
Welcome to the Opry House.
Thanks, bud. Appreciate
it. You excited?
I am excited.
You know, it's funny with me, because my music career started in like in an indie metal punk band, but the ethos of that scene is to be unique and just do your own thing. Who's to say, if I'd have started in Western music, maybe my stuff would be a little more down the center, but my whole writing style was forged in an environment where you're encouraged to color outside the lines. My motivation to play music is because those early records I heard that had story songs in them, and then further to that, when I first saw my first handful of really electric live shows in a bar, that to me was alchemy, that was magic.
Do you need any kind of cue from me? You're just talking about the instrumental outro at that point, right?
Yeah, that's
good.
We just wanted to get
out. Okay. You don't need a cue from my guitar.
When a bunch of scruffy guys could roll into your town, tumble out of the van, have a beer, and then just kick your butt, right? And you're like, it's magical. That's the only reason I play music. So the rest of it is all just noise.
And then this one, I think the funnest way to do it is I'll go, we kind of rap a bit, and I go, I think you ought to try whiskey. And then she'll go, I think you ought to try gin. And then.
I thought it was normal. I thought everybody rode steers as kids. My family are all cowboys and cattle ranchers and rodeo people for generations out west. And they came over from Denmark to Utah and Nevada originally. And then there was a big migration of people from there up to southern Alberta where I'm from.
Alberta is like the Texas of Canada. That's definitely, I feel, has influenced what he is as a songwriter and who he is as an artist.
And actually, when I got into music, it was as a 17-year-old, I found punk rock interesting and new. And so I did that for a number of years. For as alienating as rock and roll would be to a ranch family, they were pretty cool with it. But when I started writing Western music, then the light bulb went off and they were like relieved and they understood what I've been up to all this time, right? So I think once it kicked in that they understood I was representing our culture through music, I think they were okay with it after that.
I think Corb was made for the Grand Ole Opry, and I think the audience tonight is just gonna eat their hearts out.
Making his Opry debut, will you welcome Corb Lund?
Think you ought to try whiskey, babe.
Well, I think you ought to try gin.
Well, gin sounds kind of risky, babe.
Oh, whiskey makes me cringe.
I think if you're serious about it and you're in music for the long run, which I am, I'm a lifer, it eventually just pays off. If you got something to fall back on, you're gonna fall back on it, right? I have nothing to fall back on, so I'm committed to this for my life. So the longer you stick around, the more allies you make, and the more friends you make, and the more people, oh, I remember you from 10 years ago at that festival. You know, I think if you're authentic and you stick around long enough, you know, like in anything, people take you seriously.
I think you ought to try whiskey, babe.
Well, I think you ought to try gin.
I think you ought to try whiskey, baby.
Well, I think you ought to try gin.
Hey! It's a big honor to be here. That was a real blast. I really enjoyed it, and now that the nerves have settled, next time will be easier.
Thanks, everybody. Jaida Dreyer, my name is Corb.
Yeah.
Take care of yourselves.